Heather here with Pinwheel in the Wind, and today I'm going to be sharing with you toddler favorites for two-year-olds. So I'm going to start kind of chronologically. If you have a two-year-old or a kid in general, you know that the phases that they go through change very much in a year. And so what a young two-year-old is playing with is going to be completely different than what an older two-year-old is playing with. So I'm going to start with the younger toys and move into the older toys. So if you are looking for an older child, maybe, you know, fast forward through the video some and you'll see some ideas for older children. I am sure that every family knows about Little People brands and how Little People love Little People brand. But these are by far her favorite toy. They are Little People animals. And these ones actually specifically are even a twofold function because they have the letters on them. So this is a lion and it has L. And so she plays with these all of the time. It comes in a carrier case and it's full of 26 different animals, all with a different letter on them. And so she really, really, really loves these animals so much. But do you want to know something funny? We got this on sale, and I didn't really realize why it was on sale or why it was marked down, and they didn't tell me at the store. And I bring it home, and I'm like counting, are all the animals there? Yeah, all the animals are there. And then I pull out the giraffe. This giraffe that has a J there. The J for this alphabet set is for giraffe, which starts with the G, if you didn't know that. And so I found that pretty funny, but I think that was a misprint on just the set. And so we got it at a big discount. I think the normal sets aren't like that, hopefully, but they're very cute. They're easy to handle and kids love playing with these. The Little People brand also have a large selection of toys to go with their little people and little animals. My daughter loves anything farm-like, and so you can put the people in the front and it's got spaces for the animals in the back. She also loves anything that rolls, and this is once again from 1.5, and she's now 3 almost, and they still engage her just as much. This one, which I will try to link below, actually, you press the button, which I'm not going to because it makes noise, but you press the button and it actually will move itself across the floor. And so this is by far her favorite Little People gadget, and it's got spots for the animals in the back and the farmer in the front. These next two things, once again, she started playing with right at 2 years old and lost interest around 2.5. However, I put them away to use for tot school later, and when I pulled them out for tot school, she was very engaged and very happy with them again. And so they're the toys where you take a piece and you push it through the top. They both make noise and talk. So this one is a fish tank and it's got the little fish. All the fish have all the different colors, and when you place it through, a little voice comes on and actually says, black, that was a black fish. So she loved this, just the activity of putting it in from 2 to 2.5, she loved. And now we use it for working on colors. I will lay out all the fish and I'll say, find the black fish, and she'll pick up the black fish and put it in. This one is very similar. It is cookies in a cookie jar. This one is for counting though, the different chips on it. This has 8 chips. And so she has to find the one with the 8 chips and put it in. On the reverse side is the number 8. And so it's working on counting and number recognition. And once again, she puts it on in. However, the most popular one in our home, the one that she played with the absolute most, I can't find. I searched and searched for it. I know that I put it away in storage so that I would have it for my younger children when they came of that age, and I searched for it today and I couldn't find it. So I need to do that. But I did find 2 random pieces of it mixed in with her toys. And it is, once again, cookies, but they're Oreos and they fit together like an Oreo cookie. This one doesn't match, so it's not fitting perfectly together, but they fit perfectly together. And I loved this toy and she loved this toy because they come apart and on the inside are shapes. So here's an oval, here's the moon, And so normally you would find the moon and the other moon and you would place them together and it would make the cookie and then you could put it back inside the cookie jar. This was great. She knew all of her shapes, every one of them, by 2.5, maybe even earlier than that. And I really feel like this helped her a lot with that. It also helps with the fine motor of, like, if you see the moon, you have to place it right. Like, you can't place it this way and put the other piece this way and they're going to connect. It won't work. And so they have to place it just right to get it to go together perfectly. And this was an activity I would set her down with this toy and she would play with it sometimes up to an hour. Completely satisfied, quiet, just sitting there playing with this toy. So I will link this below. It's by Fisher Price. And this is probably my number one. I will tell everybody that has, you know, a young 2-year-old, get this toy. It was by far our absolute favorite. The next one is a Melissa and Doug's shape puzzle. And it's all these boards. They come in a carrier case. And it's all these boards that you can see they have the missing shapes. And it comes with all of these shape pieces that you have to put in just right to finish the picture. She really loved this when we got it. It doesn't necessarily fully engage her anymore because it's just really easy for her at this point. So I would say a 2 to 2.5 year old, again, is what this is gonna be perfect for. Maybe even a little bit younger. And then for other children, maybe a little bit older, because every child is different. But for our daughter, it was 2 to 2.5. And I love it because it comes with all of these different scenes. And once again, you can work on shapes, colors. They're big, chunky pieces, so you don't have to worry about anything, really. And what's great about it is even if you lose, like, half of the pieces, you'll still be able to play this. I loved that aspect of it. We have some other things like this, but, like, if you lose one piece, then there's some of the puzzles you can't complete because you needed that one piece of that one color. Whereas this, like, you need 2 triangles, an oval, and a circle. But there's, you know, 15 triangles in here. So if you lose a bunch of them, you'll still be able to do this. And so I really love that it came with so many extra pieces. And plus, that's also great for tot school to have so many extra pieces. And you can even sort of use them as tanagrams. So we're gonna move into a little bit older now. However, this first one is still definitely a young 2-year-old will enjoy this. But I have seen 2-year-olds up to, I think the oldest kid I've seen playing with this was 5. Once again, I'll link it below. I don't know the technical name for it anymore because we got it last Christmas. But this is one that was used then and is used now and will continue to be used across the ages. They love it. And so it is a car track. You can put your cars on and they go all the way down to the bottom. There are 2 different tracks on it. So you can put 2 cars on the 2 different tracks and have them race. They'll go different ways. There are some other gizmos and gadgets on here that make noise and they love, love, love it. Every kid that I've seen play with this has absolutely loved it for a long amount of time. And so this is definitely a favorite in our home. The next thing I want to show you is the Melissa and Doug matches board. My daughter did get this last Christmas, so once again, right before 2 years old, and she loved it then. However, I do feel like it is gauged towards a little bit of an older child. My daughter tended to be a little bit on the advanced side, so I do feel like this would engage an older child. By older, I mean like 2.5. But there are all these different latches. And it's basically learning how to unlatch all of these different things. The doors open and inside is a picture of something. One thing that is great about this is it works on the latches. It also can be work for colors because as you can see, they're all different colors. And when you open up the inside of it, whatever is inside is the same color. And the other thing it's great on is the numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inside of the different doors, there is that number of an animal. So here there are 6 orange fish and you can have them count and then close the door and latch it shut. And so my daughter really, really loves this. And like I said, there's many different ways that you can use it. So we really love this. The next thing is button nail. It comes with this board, which everything fits nicely inside of the board. and you take the page. There are multiple different pages, different scenes. You put it right on top, and then you take the, they call them buttons, out from the inside, and it's color matching. So you want a pink button here with the pink. And so it's taking them, putting them in the hole, pushing them in, and finding all of the right pieces for the right area. When she was really engaged with this, she would easily play it for a half hour. She would do every single page before she would want to stop. And once again, it keeps them quiet, which is amazing for the parent. And it's something that they actually really enjoy. And it works with color, fine motor skill, and cognitive abilities, which I really love. The next thing would be this Fisher-Price robot. This we gave her when she was younger, didn't really catch her interest much until closer to that 2.5 age range. So I'm gonna say this one is gonna be 2.5 to around 5 years old is what this one would be geared towards. It is a little robot that moves and sings and dances, and it lights up, and it has several different functions. So one is a recorder. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but it it says, when my tummy turns red, say something and I'll repeat it back to you. So I don't know if you can hear it, but it is repeating back what I said in a robot voice and singing and dancing and lighting flashing up to it. There are other buttons you can press. One of them just plays music. One of them counts. One of them does a dance and freeze game. And so it's like, one, two, three, dance. And the robot will dance and light up and flash. And then it's like, and freeze. Now dance. So it's very, very engaging, very entertaining, and really holds their attention. And this will be a family favorite for a long time to come. So the great thing about 2 years old is that they love puzzles. Here are some of our favorites. So this is by Digeco. It's these animal puzzles. It advances in difficulty. And so there's 4-piece, there's 6-piece, and there's 2 9-piece puzzles. When she first did this, she needed a lot of help. We started right at about 2.5, and she needed a lot of help from mommy. After us doing it a couple of times together, though, she started being able to do them herself. And the 9-piece ones are actually quite advanced, and she can completely do them by herself now. This would keep her entertained and engaged for 30 plus minutes, which as a mommy, we love that. And so they're very large pieces, at least in the 4-piece ones, but they're all pretty large. And if you can see, the pictures that they make when they're all done are very, very cute. So along the same lines, only increasing in difficulty a little bit, is this, in case you can't tell, very well-loved puzzle called The Animal Parade by Sims Tabak. What is great about this is it looks really big and really complex and really like a 2-year-old can't do that. It's a 48-piece puzzle, which once again, 2-year-old can't do that. But what is great about it and makes it to where a 2-year-old can do it is that it is 4-piece puzzles. It's a bunch of 4-piece square puzzles that can link together to make the big 7-foot-long 48-piece puzzle. But really, there's 4 pieces that make up this rooster. A tip or trick on how to do this more effortlessly with your 2-year-old is that I would take out all the pieces and set them up for her. And so that she would have all 4 pieces of the rooster in a pile and all 4 pieces of the doggy in a pile. But an easy way to do that is to make a symbol or letter on the back of the puzzle piece. So here there is a capital E. So all 4 of the wrapped pieces have a capital E on it. So I can quickly just open it up, flip them all over, and just sort them into the piles and then give her the piles. And she's able to put all of the animals together. We started working on this right at 2.5, and she loved putting the animals together, but needed a lot of help actually putting it into the like 7-foot-long thing, connecting all the animals together. And right at about 2 years and like 7 months, she was actually able to connect the train completely herself too, which she took a lot of pride and accomplishment in. And what's really, really great about that is that it keeps her engaged and entertaining and critically thinking for a good, sometimes even up to an hour. Now that she's more used to it and she can do it really quickly, she can actually put this whole puzzle together in 15 minutes now. Which is great, but at the same time, kind of sad for mommy. This says 2 years old and up. She started playing with this at 2.5, and she loved it then. So it definitely can be used for a 2.5-year-old. However, it does get quite advanced quite quickly, which is why I will say closer to the 3 years age range. But it is called Bunny Peekaboo by Smart Games. If you haven't heard of Smart Games, I love them. It comes with all of these, and there are many, 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 60 different cards that have challenges on them. And so it starts super easy with just the bunny sitting next to the yellow piece. And so you will find the bunny and the yellow piece, and you will set it on the table so it looks the same as the picture. Now it comes with these four pieces. And it actually gets quite advanced though. Let's go like halfway through the deck. Now you've got the blue square, the red triangle, and the bunny, and you actually have to work to create them at just the right angle, which is why I say this is maybe more towards a three-year-old. A two-year-old could maybe do, my two-year-old, she can do all the green ones, but once we get into the orange, she can't do them anymore. But they are very challenging as they move on. So it's a game that really grows with your child and they get quite advanced. So it's a great toy that she really loves. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the like button and leave a comment down below. What is something that your two-year-old loved, like hands down favorite toy? My two-year-old loved this toy. So that I can see and other people can see what are some other great options. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget, I'll link everything down below for you to easily find them. Until next time, bye.